This video is because of this comment. Listen, on this channel, no request is a bad request. Or maybe not. Probably I need to be more careful about that statement. Just because. Okay, today though, we're walking through Final Cut Pro's best export settings for social media, step by step. All right, let's do this. Actually, don't do this. Let's talk about what not to do first and why. Don't use these YouTube and Facebook export presets. Why? Because Final Cut Pro will compress your video a lot. And when you're gonna import your video on any of these social media platforms, it's already gonna be compressed. So if you let Final Cut Pro do it too, that's double compression. So the first thing you need to do before we talk about exporting, we gotta set up the timeline correctly. Let's go to File, New Project. And for anything vertical like Reels on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube Shorts, just pick the 1080 by 1920 resolution. This is the same as 9 by 16. And for the rate, you can choose either 30p or 60p if you want that extra smoothness. I personally like 24p or maybe even 23.98p because those are the ones closest to cinema. Those are the ones closest to film, to, you know, cinematic if you want. And I haven't really seen any big difference, but you can pick whatever you want. For the codec, you can just use the Apple ProRes 422. This codec has a very good quality compression and it's still pretty good for your machine to work with. It's not gonna be too bulky. And for the audio, I just use stereo at 48 kilohertz. As far as the horizontals, I'd say keep it at 16 by 9 or 1920 by 1080. As much as possible. Or maybe just for YouTube, I shoot at 1080p, but edit in a timeline of 3840 by 1920 to up-res it to 4K, and it comes out as 4K on YouTube. That's what I did with this video you're watching right now. And so you can let me know if there's a, you know, there's a big difference, what the quality is. Of course, you have to check your phone if you're actually watching in 4K or not, but this is 1080p up-res to 4K. But for Facebook though, and maybe LinkedIn too, the best resolution is 1080 by 1080. Of course, you can still go with 1920 by 1080 for widescreen, but it keeps everything in this very small strip. Just like this. So for those two platforms, Square is still the most ideal, but of course it also depends on the kind of content you create or your goals with it. And that's a big thing too. What do you want to do? What do you want to achieve? What's your vision behind the content you're trying to create? But that's the thing. You shoot your video with some settings in your camera, and then you bring it to your editing software of choice, and then it's still going to be compressed before you actually work on it. And then you export it with some compression, and then social media, when you upload it, will still compress it. So the trick is to minimize the compressions as much as possible without losing the quality that we want. All right, let's go to export. Finally, it's on the top right of the screen right here, and we're gonna use this export file option here, the default one. You can also press Command E if you like shortcuts, and that will get you here too. Go to settings, and with the format, I usually just go with video and audio, but you can try social platforms. But I recommend that you choose H.264 multipass for better quality in codec. But if you use video and audio in format, just make sure to choose H.264. This will keep your file size small, but your video will still be at a very high quality. The rest, like the resolution, the frame rate, bit rate, the audio settings, will match your project timeline settings, and that's why we set those up first. And then you can just click next when you're ready, and boom, you're done. Now I gotta say this again because this is important. Your camera settings when you shoot the video also matters. So there is that too. You gotta work on that, build your skill on that, practice and practice. That will help you in post, and of course it's also gonna help you when you export the video and when you deliver the video. By the way, which social media platform do you post on the most? If you guys got any value from this one, subscribe for more Final Cut Pro tips, and I'll see you in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.